Panini made some really big news recently with their Charles Barkley announcement, getting him for autographs. How did that all come together?
And it's been years in the making. You know, he's one of the guys that we really looked at when Panini came into the marketplace of wanting to get him into product. And it's been years. You know, he's been a guy that hasn't been on trading cards for, you know, over 20 years. Hasn't had a lot of memorabilia out there. And so he was one of these guys that we just constantly tried to find a way to go out and, you know, meet with and have conversations with to try to get him to come in and be a part of the Panini family. And we just had an opportunity a few months ago where we were able to sit with him face to face and kind of explain, you know, how much the marketplace has changed, how much trading cards has changed in terms of their presentation, what they look like, and the value, and all of those things, and why it would be so meaningful for him to be a part of that. And it worked.
So I see the autographed basketball behind you there.
Yeah.
As far as his autograph deal goes, what does it all cover?
It includes autograph trading cards and memorabilia. Also includes the ability to include him in all of our NBA trading card products and collegiate products. So you'll see him as, you know, an Auburn Tiger. You'll see him throughout his NBA career. You know, if you grew up as a Sixer fan or even watching him as a Sixer, you'll get that. You've got him as a Phoenix Sun and Houston Rocket, and then, of course, as a member of the Dream Team. So in his USA basketball uniform.
Now, as far as price go, I know he's in noir. He's going to be in the bigger products like Falls, but what about some of the smaller products like a Hoops per se for fans who maybe can't afford the higher end products?
At a minimum, you're going to definitely have trading cards of Charles in all of our products going forward.
All right, so I'll ask you this. Barkley is like one of the last big unknowns there. If you had to pick a name, who would you say is the next kind of big unknown? If you could pick someone to bring it to a deal, who would you pick?
Man, they don't get much bigger than Barkley. You think about, you know, some of the other guys, but, you know, Barkley has this presence that has lasted longer than his game. You know, because of what he does on TNT, because of his personality, people just love him. I think it really kind of elevates, you know, what he does and what he can bring to the trading card category. So it's hard. I mean, there's definitely guys out there that, you know, we would love to have in our product. But in terms of, you know, the caliber of Barkley's status, there's really not anyone out there.